Guess what's the easiest way to bond? We all do it. We do it in family gatherings, when friends meet up, at office water coolers, or when we gang up against someone else. We judge. When you talk about someone else, most people will gladly join in. We all judge others. All the time. We judge their clothes, their hair, the car they drive, their accents, or the religion they belong to, their parenting, their values. We judge and we judge and we judge. Judging someone or something is what we do automatically. I've done it so many times myself. I judge others when I could very well be in their shoes. Because you see, if we get off our high horses, we will realize that we judge only that which we see in ourselves. Surprised? So that's what I will focus on in this episode. How to stop judging and start living. Hi, I'm Sheila and this is Lumiere 24. Light on! Awareness is the first step to change. So before we decide to stop judging, let's understand why we judge in the first place. I think the main reason we judge others is because we're scared. You see, we are hardwired for survival. And when we see something which is different, our first reaction is to diss it. When people are scared, they try to feel better by putting others down. Which is why making fun of the teacher or the principal or the boss in office is so popular. Another reason we judge is because we are insecure. When we are insecure and are unhappy with who we are, we try to put other people down. We want to feel good by making others feel bad. Now we come to the second most important question. Why should we stop judging anyway? This is my opinion, but I think judgments put negativity into the world. No matter how you rationalize your judgments, they are not bringing anything good into this world. They bring others down. They bring you down. They make the world a more unhappy place. Can you imagine what world would be like if we try to understand other people rather than judging them? This reminds me of a story I read. Imagine you're walking in a park and you see a beautiful dog. You bend down to pet the dog. The dog snarls and you withdraw your hand and say, "Whoa, nasty dog." And then you notice that the dog's leg is caught in some bramble and you realize it's snarling out of pain. Get what I'm saying? Being judgmental also makes you judge you. When you judge others, you're probably judging yourself pretty harshly as well. Because life is a mirror. What you see out there and judge exists in some way or manner in you too. And I know you've not considered this, but sometimes people may find out what you've said. Think about what you say. Would you say that to his or her face? If not, it's probably best left unsaid and unthought. First thing to do is be more mindful. Although judgment is a natural instinct, try to catch yourself before you speak or send that nasty email. Pause. See if you can understand where the person may be coming from. Try to rephrase your critical internal thought into a positive one, or at the least, a neutral one. After all, like that dog in the story I just told you, we really don't know the reasons behind someone's behavior. I love what Will Smith said. Never underestimate the pain of a person, because in all honesty, everyone is struggling. Some people are better at hiding it than others. Sometimes we may be judging someone for something that we do ourselves or have done. For instance, there I was yelling at a guy on a motorbike for driving on the wrong side of the road. And I suddenly remembered how I myself drive on the wrong side of the road when I'm late and I'm trying to get my kids onto the school bus. Of course, my excuse is that if I miss the bus, I have to drive them another 14 miles. Who's to say that my story is better than the biker's? And most importantly, stop judging yourself. The more we judge ourselves, the more we'll judge others. Feel good about you. Brené Brown puts it so well when she says, we are hard on each other because we're using each other as a launching pad out of our own perceived deficiency. The key word here is perceived. Focus on the positive aspects of you And then it will be a lot easier to focus on the positive aspects of others. Like all habits, judging is also a habit. We have done it for so long and so often that replacing it is not going to be easy. To help you along, here's a spiffy little tool that I have borrowed from Neil Donald Walsh. This tool is called JLM or Just Like Me. So here's what you do. Every time you see something and the urge to judge wells up, repeat the mantra, I am that, I am. Whether you see a beggar on the road and you want to chide them, or a waiter drops your coffee, or your partner seems more nasty to you, or your child is in one of the hissy moods, repeat, I am that, I am. Reminding yourself that all that you see is just a reflection of you. You can do it for all the nice judgments you have too. If your partner is loving and affectionate, if you see a beautiful flower, if your boss is in a jovial mood, repeat, I am that, I am. This is a beautiful mantra to repeat, and it automatically calms your mind and prevents you from doing your most favorite exercise, jumping to conclusions and reacting instead of responding. Is this an easy tool to use? Probably not. It takes time, it takes effort, two things that we're usually short on. But putting in that effort and taking that time to pause before judging helps build bridges. Remember, we are more alike than different. And it is only our judgments which cause us to feel separate. Like John Lennon sings in his song, imagine all the people living life in peace. Feel free to use the comment box below to share your views. And do share this video with your family and friends. Spread the light, folks.